From this tutorial, we are starting new series for Autodesk Inventor. In this series of tutorials, we will learn complete Autodesk Inventor from start to finish. In this first tutorial, we will learn sketch basics, as creating correct sketch is the first important step in creating any complicated 3D model accurately. I request you to watch this complete tutorial from start to finish to get complete knowledge about Inventor sketch concepts. I also request you to subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon to receive new video notification every alternate Monday, Wednesday and Saturday. Please also like and share this video. When we start Inventor, it shows this user interface. We will learn about user interface in more detail in coming lectures. Right now, we will concentrate on creating sketches and we will directly start learning about it. So, click here on New. Then, if you want to create model in inches, then click here on English. And you will have to select this standard inch.ipt. IPT is the extension for Inventor part. And if you want to create part in millimeter, then you will have to click here on metric and then select this standard mm IPT and click here on create. Then to start sketch, click here on start 2D sketch. Keyboard shortcut for sketch is S. The characters shown in bracket symbol are the shortcuts for that command, which you can activate from keyboard by typing that character. So click here. Then as we are not going to use this sketch for creating any 3D model, therefore you can choose any plane. Suppose I will select this horizontal plane. Then to pan it, press middle mouse button and drag the mouse. You can also pan by clicking here on pan command, pressing first mouse button and dragging the mouse. And to come out, just right click and click on OK. Then here you can see that unit of our drawing is millimeter. And if you want to change unit, then you will have to click here on tools and click on document settings and click here on units. And from here you can choose your desired unit. Suppose I will keep this millimeter as it is and click on OK. Then click on sketch to bring back this sketch toolbar. Then first command we are going to learn is line. Keyboard shortcut is L. Click on line. Then what is to be done next is shown in this area. So here it is showing that select start of line. So always ensure that you start your drawing using this 00 origin point. If you use this origin point in your sketch, then it will be easy to fully constrain your sketch. So click there. Then take your cursor away. If you want straight line, take your cursor below. Once your lines become straight, it will show this symbol. And if you take it vertical also, it will show the same symbol. The meaning of this symbol is that your line is straight, that is either in 0, 90, 180 or 270 degree. Then specify length of your line. Suppose it is 50, then press enter. So here this line of 50 length is created. And if it is not properly visible, you can use your middle mouse button. If you rotate your middle mouse button towards monitor, then it will zoom minus. And if you rotate it towards you, then it will zoom plus. You can also use zoom command from here. Click here on zoom. Then press first mouse button and drag below, so it will zoom plus. And if you drag it up, then it will zoom minus. So zoom plus, zoom minus, then right click and OK. Then I want to create perfect vertical line. So take your cursor in this direction and ensure that it is showing 90 degree angle or it is showing this perpendicular constraint. Then again specify length. I want it to be 50, press enter. Then again zoom minus, then pan it below. So in this way you can create line by specifying dimensions. And if you want to create line freehand and give dimension later on, then that is also possible. Suppose we will create one freehand shape. Suppose I will click here, then I will take it below I am ensuring that it is at 90 degree. Click. Then on this side, click. Then suppose I want to create one arc here. Then for that, take your cursor to this end point. Press and hold first mouse button and drag the mouse. So it will create arc, and don't release it until you reach the end point of your arc. So I want to connect it to this end point. So just release it. So here this tangent arc is created. Then to come out of the line command, just right click and click on OK. So here this shape is created. Now in this shape there are two colors. Some lines are in black color and some objects are in purple color. The meaning of purple color is that it is underdefined. That means it will need some dimensions or constraints to fully define it. And meaning of black color is that it is fully defined. It has all the constraints and dimensions. And in this area also you can see that it is giving a message, two dimensions needed. So to give dimension, you will have to click here on dimension. Keyboard shortcut is D. Click. Then click on this line. Take your cursor on this side and click. Then to change this dimension, just click on it once. So it will show this dialog box. There you can key in your required dimension. Suppose I want it to be 25, enter. As I given this length, you will see that this line has become black because we have specified location for this line. Then suppose I want to give radius of this arc. So just click on it, take it outside or inside, click, again click and specify your radius. Suppose it is 15, enter. So here you will see that our sketch is fully defined, and here also it is showing the message fully constrained. Then after fully constrained, if you try to give some parameter, then it will make it over constrained. Suppose if I try to give length of this line, just click, take it outside and click. So here it is giving error. Adding this dimension will over constrain this sketch. Choose accept to create a driven dimension. Okay, I will click here on accept. So here you will see that this dimension is placed with bracket symbol. The meaning of bracket symbol is that this is a driven dimension. And driven dimension means when I will change any other dimension, this dimension will change automatically without giving any indications. Suppose if I change this radius, just click, and suppose I will make it 10, enter. So here you will see that this has changed automatically. And suppose if you want to make it driving dimension and make this radius as a driven dimension, then for that just take your cursor over the dimension, right click. Now here that option is not available because right now we are in dimensions command. So just press escape and again escape. So ensure that there is no active command, otherwise required option will not be shown. So just take your cursor over this dimension, right click, and here is the option driven dimension. So just click on it, click outside. So here you will see that this has become under constrained because both are the driven dimension. So in this way, this has been converted into driven dimension. And now I want to convert this dimension into driving dimension. So just take your cursor over the dimension, right click and click here on driven dimension. Click outside. So here it has been converted into driving dimension. Now in this sketch we have created straight lines and arc. Suppose I want to create inclined line. Then you can directly type L for line. So here line got activated. Then take your cursor to this end point and click and take your cursor on this side. When you create inclined line, you will see that it is showing length and angle, both the parameters. So at first you will have to specify length, suppose it is 40. Then to specify angle, you will have to press tab. Now here it is in angle. So you can type here your desired angle. Now this angle is measured from this vertical line. Suppose I want this angle to be 45. Press enter. So here you will see that this line is created of 40 length and angle is 45 from this vertical line. Then I want to connect it to this point. So click there and press escape. So here we have created this line with length and angle. Then I want to specify this angle from this horizontal line and not from this vertical line. Right now our sketch is fully constrained. So what we will have to do, we will have to convert this angle into driven angle. So for that, take your cursor there, right click, click on driven dimension. Now here it is under constraint. Then for angle, click here on dimension. Then select this line and this line. Then take your cursor here, click. Then to change the angle, again click and specify your angle. Press enter. So in this way, you can place angle manually also or automatically also. So now all the lines are main line. Suppose I want to convert this line into construction line or reference line. Then for that, click on this line, right click and click on construction and click outside. So in this way, you can convert any object into construction object by clicking and right clicking on it. And if you want to remove all these objects and create some other objects, then for that, take your cursor in the empty space, press and hold first mouse button and drag the mouse. So it will show this red color window and ensure that all the objects are inside this window and release the first mouse button. So it will select all the objects, then press delete button on keyboard. So in this way, you can remove all the objects using delete. Then suppose I want to create center lines. For that, just click here on center line and click here on line. Then suppose I want to create one horizontal center line. So just click here and take your cursor on this side, ensure that it is straight and click. Then to come out of this line command, just right click and cancel. Then type L for line, or you can also press enter to repeat last command. Then click here, take your cursor below and click, right click, cancel, then enter. So in Inventor, you can also use spacebar as enter. Suppose I have normal line and I want to convert that line into center line. So I will just cancel this option and I will create here one normal line. Then right click, cancel. Then to convert this line into center line, just select this line, right click and click here on center line. So in this way also you can create center line. Then here you will see that all the center lines are in purple color. That means they are underdefined. So to make them fully constrained, we will have to apply some constraint. If you want to view what are the current constraints applied, just click here on show all constraints. So here right now you will see that horizontal and vertical constraints are applied. Now these lines are not fixed. If I click on these lines and drag the mouse, you will see that those can be moved very easily. So I will have to fix them. So for fixing, one of the best constraint is coincident. So just click here on coincident, then select this line and select this point. So here this line got black, that means it is fully constrained. Same way, select on this line and this point. Then to constrain this line, we will have to specify one dimension. So click here on general dimension, click on this line and this line, then click. Then to change dimension, single click and specify dimension. Suppose it is 100, enter. Then pan it and zoom minus it. Then to cancel dimension, press escape. Then to create circles, click here on center point circle. Keyboard shortcut is Ctrl Shift C. Click. Then select center of circle. Click. Take your cursor away. Then specify diameter of circle. Suppose it is 50. Enter. Then again take your cursor here. So here you will see that both lines has become purple. The meaning of that is that it is selecting the intersection point. And it is also showing intersection symbol here. So click, take it away, specify diameter, suppose it is 70, enter. Then again right click, cancel. Then suppose I want to create tangent lines. For that, click here on line. Then click here on circle. Then take your cursor on this circle, take it ahead, and once tangent symbol is shown, click there. Then right click, cancel. Now tangent is applied on this side, but it is not applied on this side. So to apply tangent on this side, you will have to click here on tangent. Then select this circle and this line. So here tangent is applied on this side also. Then press escape. Then suppose I will again create one line, click. Then this time I will create line away from object. Suppose I will click here and here. Right click, cancel. Then to apply tangent, again click here on tangent. Then select this line, this circle. Again this line and this circle. So here both the tangents are applied. Then suppose I want to remove these parts. For that, at first cancel this tangent, press escape. Then click here on trim. Keyboard shortcut is X. Then directly take your cursor on the object you want to remove and click. So the objects which will be removed are shown in dotted format. Just click, those will be removed. So just zoom there. You can also use zoom window. For that, click here on this arrow. And here is zoom window. Then click first point for the window, click second point. So here it has been zoomed. Then to remove this object, click here. Then for zoom extend, you can also double click your middle mouse button. So it will be zoom extend. And if you want to zoom using middle mouse button, then take your cursor in the area you want to zoom and just rotate your middle mouse button towards you. In this way also it will zoom perfectly. Then suppose I want to trim this internal circle also, just click on it and this. Then again double click middle mouse button, then remove these arcs also, and again we will remove here also. Then double click middle mouse button. So here this object has been created perfectly. Then suppose I want to mirror this portion on opposite side around this center line. Then for that click here on mirror, then select these objects, then right click, continue. Here you will see that it has been shifted to mirror line. Then click here on mirror line. Here also it is giving message select mirror line. So click here on mirror line, then right click and OK. So here this mirror is created. And suppose I want to remove this part, then again for that trim, you can type X for trim and click and click. So after trim it got under constraint. So for that actually this dimension is removed. So we will dimension it. Click on general dimension. Select this R. Take it inside and click. Same way here. Click. So here this object is fully constrained. And if you want to increase length of this center line, press escape, click on this line, then take your cursor to this point, press and hold first mouse button and drag the mouse. So in this way you can change length of that line also. So we have learned some of the basic concept. In the next tutorial we will solve some exercises based on what we learn in this tutorial. In the lecture after that we will learn 3D concepts and we will also create some 3D models. Please like, share and subscribe. So thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.